Since the dawn of time, humans have dedicated their life toward finding the most delectable of treats. Today, on this very special episode of Your Everyday Nerd, we'll be going back to the candy aisle to take a look at the candy from the 1950s. Stick around, Daddy-O, as we check out this blast from the past on Your Everyday Nerd.
Oh, so many flavors came rushing back.
Are you an everyday nerd? Hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss the next episode.
Yo, welcome back to Your Everyday Nerd. I'm your host, Zach Snyder. If you're new around here on YN, we pull from every corner of nerd culture to talk about anything and everything that piques my interest. Today, it's candy time. I was perusing the web the other day, and I came across this website called oldtimecandy.com. This is a 2-pound box of candy from the 1950s. There are over 30 pieces of candy in this box, so we got a ways to go to figure out what all is in here, whether I'm gonna like it or not, and to determine whether or not the 1950s were a good time to be around. Now, to make our ranking easy, we're going to be using my handy dandy notebook, which is a piece of paper inside of my copy of Zodiac, the shocking true story of the hunt for the nations. It has a piece of paper in it. And we're going to write down all the candy and determine which ones are good, which ones sucked, and which ones I would actually go out and get again. So let's open up the box. Let's get into the candy. There's a lot. I don't know if I should have done that or not. Let's mix it up. Let's start light. We have here a Charleston Chew vanilla flavor. Let's open that bad boy up. Let's try it. Oh, okay. Got chocolate everywhere. Glad I got a plate. Okay. Oh, that's pretty good. A vanilla nougat, get chocolate covering. Charleston Chew going on the good candy tier. Oh no, there's chocolate everywhere. All right, well, the next thing we got are Sugar Babies. Delicious candy-coated milk caramel Sugar Babies. I would not be opposed to be if somebody would be willing to pay me the right amount of money. But we will save. There's our first candy to drop the floor. Does she see one or two of them? Ooh, okay. That is certainly, it's really hard. I was expecting a chewy, delectable treat. Man, no thank you. I will save this and give this to somebody else. I'm probably gonna like put a lot of this in a bag and like give it to my family or something. If Charleston Chew is like a 4 out of 5, I'm still chewing it. I'm giving Sugar Babies a 1 out of 5. I'm not a big fan of hard candies. I do like caramel, but I couldn't chew that. That hurt. Next up on the list is the Lance Fresh Roasted Peanut Bar Original. I would not consider this candy. Peanut, sugar, corn syrup, and salt. So yeah, bon appetit. I haven't had anything peanut related in a while. I'm not a big fan of nuts. But it's solid enough. Like I would eat this, not regularly. It is a little too sweet for me. That corn syrup is like not good for you. Peanut bar, giving it a 3 out of 5. Here we have the Chick-O Stick, crunchy peanut butter rolled in toasted coconuts. Here's what it looks like. Let's try the choco stick. This is okay. It's peanut butter and coconut. I don't know what else to say. It's getting a 2.5 out of 5 for me. Let's mix it up. Good old Smarties. Smarties are good. I will say, there used to be the Smarties epidemic back in elementary school. People would crush these things and then like snort them like they were drugs. And I never understood that. So today, we're gonna, that's good. Smarties is like a solid 4.5 out of 5. Next we have the Chunky, which is in kind of like a York peppermint patty kind of wrapper. But this says it's milk chocolate with peanuts and raisins. I'm not opposed to raisins. I like raisins. I am quite worried about this. This is what it looks like. It's just straight up raisins. Let's try it. I mean, For some reason, the combination doesn't quite do it for me. I'm going to have to give that one a 2 out of 5. That might actually be like closer to bad than it is good. Let's do another fruit flavor thing. We have the Safty Pops. It's a lollipop. This is like the lollipop you get from the bank, if I can open it. Yeah, that tastes like a lollipop. It's like a cherry, which kind of sucks. I'm not a big fan of cherries, so it's fine. You know, I'm gonna be honest with you, actually. Like, on the rating of candies that I plan on getting in the future, and remind you guys, I'm not the biggest fan of candy as a whole. I think that there are some really good candies that I relish getting at times. I like to savor them for a long time. I'm not the kind of guy that's gonna go to the grocery store and buy a bunch of candy and then eat it all in one sitting. Which is just kind of what we're doing here, but that's not what I usually do. I'm never gonna buy a lollipop in my life at this point. It's getting a 1 out of 5 for me. Bro, these look interesting. These are Chuckles. This is a fat-free jelly candy. I'm hoping it's gonna be like orange slices. That's what it kind of feels and looks like. It's got sugar coating. Let's try it. Well, that's good. Oh yeah, it's just orange slices. This is getting a 5 out of 5 for me. I would eat that whole pack right now if I didn't have 20 other candies to come next. Next on our list, we have a wrapper that doesn't quite... Oh, it's a candy pipe. Looks like it's a gummy pipe. It is very sticky. I also don't like the idea of putting this in my mouth on the internet. So I think I'm just going to cut to after I've gotten a bite or whatever. Ugh, I hate that. Oh, thank you. I'm giving that one a 0 out of 5. I don't think we can go further down than that one. Let's try a classic Whoppers. I like Whoppers. I haven't had them in like, probably like 8 years, but I remember enjoying Whoppers. Malts, chocolate, milk balls. Basically what I remember them as. Pretty good. Probably gonna give these a 3.5 out of 5, but I like Whoppers. Let's switch it up to, I'm scared of some of these, man. Lifesavers. The hard candy Lifesavers. It's also the butter rum flavor. Woo! So you pop that bad boy out. Should I get the wrapper off somehow? We almost got this open. Oh! So many flavors came rushing back. All right, we've gotten into the dreaded butter rum hard candy. It's very hard and sticky. Yeah, this tastes awful. I gotta spit it out. No sir. The candy pipe was awful and it was inexcusable. I think this might be worse. I thought for sure the Lifesavers would be good. Let's change it up with something I like. Tootsie Rolls. Good old classic Tootsie Rolls. You can never go wrong with a Tootsie Roll. I like it. I want it. I got it. Oh yeah. Classic. The Tootsie Roll gets a solid 4 out of 5. You know, we had the Sugar Babies, and they were not that great. Let's try the Sugar Daddy. It is a milk caramel pop, which I've already established, and I'm not, like, going out of my way to buy pops. Let's see if it's chewy or if it's hard. It's very hard. Very hard. I'm going to have to put that on the do not eat list. Also be getting a 1 out of 5. I'm sorry. I don't know what the sugar brand did to me. It's just too much. We got a couple of concerning ones that I'm trying to hold off for a little bit longer. Let's try the Wrigley's Double Mint Chewing Gum. While I am not that big of a candy person, I am even less so a gum person. Last time I chewed gum was probably in like middle school, just because a friend of mine was like, hey, you want a piece of gum? Yeah, sure, bro. Hopefully this will make my breath not smell bad after all this bad candy. Yeah, that's why I don't eat gum. So, it's pretty flavorful. It's got that mint taste. It's probably helping my my breath at some point. And no more flavor. The flavor is gone in real time that quickly. Give it a 2.5. Unfortunately, though, that is not the only gum that we have. We do have the Black Jack Chewing Gum, which is actually a brand I've never heard of. Oh, it's got like a licorice smell. You know? as much as I am not a gum person, this is an even worse version of gum. I'm gonna give the Blackjack chewing gum a 2 out of 5. I'm really interested in this one. It is a Zag Nut. This is a peanut butter, crunchy peanut butter toasted coconut. I will try it, see if I like it.
Try it, you'll like it.
It resembles the Chico stick quite a lot. It is pretty much that. It's not bad. The Zag Nut reminds me of another more popular candy, but as of now, I cannot remember it.
Butterfinger. It reminds me of the Butterfinger.
That is the Zag Nut. I'm gonna give that a 3.5 out of 5. Next up, we have the world's greatest candy necklace. I have not had one of these since I was a child. I did remember like kids just like put this around their greasy neck and then like eat on it. And I did not do that because I knew better. Let me just bite into part of it. It's kind of like Smarties, actually. The tough part is that it's on a stupid, like lace. I'm gonna give it a 4, because Smarties is easier to eat. But yeah, got a candy necklace, man. It checks out. Next up, we have the Vanilla Turkish Taffy by Bonomo. Smack it, crack it. Apparently, they want you to crack it or something, because that is hard. There it is. How to eat Bonomo Turkish Taffy. Hold bar and palm of the hand. Strike against a flat surface. Break into bite-sized pieces. Let candy melt in your mouth. Okay. Let's really try to...
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's...
Oh, my goodness. Flavor's fine. And like, it's not like a bad taste by any means. It is not worth the effort. Not even close. We're giving this a 1. Next up on the list is... Another taffy? Oh man. Black Taffy, Primrose Candy Company. My guess is this is gonna be licorice flavor. Ugh, it's like green. Why? Okay. No, mm-mm. It's too chewy, it's too licorice-y, it's, oh thank you. Good thing they gave us 2, right? It's getting another 1 for me. We need something good, man. Let's try the classic Peanut Caramel Bar Paydays. I remember liking Paydays. They're my mom's favorite candy, so she will be getting the rest of this when I'm done. This looks very familiar to the peanut bar that we had earlier. I'm assuming this will probably have a little more sugar in it or something. Actually, no, because this has caramel in it. This is probably healthier than the peanut bar. Yeah, I like the Paydays. Not a candy I'm going out of my way to get, but I'm gonna give it a 4 out of 5. On top of that, the Payday sequel, Payday 2, is a pretty fun game, and I definitely recommend it. I need more drink.
Welcome to your Kodak moment.
All right, boys. Welcome back to Carton of Day, the show where we smoke an entire pack of cigarettes to determine whether or not it's good or bad. Today is Lucky Lights candy. Let's go. I never quite understood this, but there were candy cigarettes given out to kids. They are supposed to resemble actual cigarettes. I mean, I guess. It also looks like it's like pure sugar. Yeah, yeah. There's nothing else in here. I mean, there's like corn syrup. It's not even like regular sugar. This isn't as bad for your health as regular cigarettes are, but like they're pretty bad. It doesn't taste bad. Man, it tastes fine. Probably gonna get like a 2 out of 5 from you. Do you like beans? Got you covered. Boston baked beans, candy coated peanuts. Why? Why is this a thing? If you can zoom in on that, that'd be great. It's just a chocolate covered peanut. Sorry, candy. Candy coated peanut. This is what I don't like about. It's gonna be a no for me. I don't even know, like chocolate covered peanut, sure. The candy coating. No, sir. No. Beans are getting a 1 out of 5. Awful idea, awful taste. No, thank you. All right, let's switch over to the Goldenberg's Peanut Chews Original Dark. I do like dark chocolate, so hopefully I like this. Little bite-sized segments. Break one off. Here we go. Okay. It do be chewy, but not too chewy like the licorice. This is a solid candy. I'm giving the peanut chew a 3.5 out of 5. Let's try Bit of Honey. This is a, for lack of better words, a grandma candy. I'm gonna try to, it is very, very tough. Ugh, I'm not gonna be able to. This is the kind of candy that you just be like keeping in your mouth for too long, which I don't like. As far as flavor goes, it's fine. 2.5 out of 5. Next we have the Doties, which does not give a description, so let's just try it. It looks like another hard candy. It feels like another hard candy. No. It's actually kind of chewy, kind of soft. It's like Cowtails. It's the same company that makes Cowtails. It's got that creamy center and it's got that caramel outside. It's missing the like powdered sugar on the outside of it, but it's pretty good. I have, however, unfortunately reached the point of no return where any new candy that I put in my mouth practically tastes like an amalgamation of the last 30 that I've tried. We are down to the last 7. I have been recording for 54 minutes. Let's just get through these. Number 1, Babe Ruth. I haven't had a Babe Ruth in a while either, much like Paydays. It made a mess.
I want to be like messy.
Babe Ruths are very similar to the Paydays. They both got peanuts. This one has caramel and a nugget feeling, which I quite enjoy actually. Reminds me a lot of like Milky Ways with peanuts. Again, not the kind of candy that I'm going out of my way to go purchase all the time. But if I'm given one, like I don't mind it. It's pretty good. I'm also going to give this one a 4 out of 5. Next up, we have the Tootsie Pop. How many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? Let's find out. 1, 2, 3. I'm not breaking that. That would hurt my mouth. It's a Tootsie Pop. I remember liking Tootsie Pops a lot as a kid. It's just like a chocolate lollipop with the Tootsie Roll filling. Obviously, I'm not going out of my way to get Tootsie Pops these days. I'm a mature adult, but it's good enough. I'm gonna give this a 3.5 out of 5. I'm not about to find out how many takes it does take to get to the center of that. The world will never know. I'm sure there's a video out there though. Food Theory. Mr. Matt Pat, the Game Theory, I bet he's done it on his Food Theory channel.
117.
All right, we're down to the last 5. I'm gonna show you what we have left. We have Jolly Ranchers, Jaw Busters, we have the Atomic Fireball, and we have the Candy Buttons. Oh, and you can't forget about the good old wax lips. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the grape Jolly Rancher. I know how I feel about Jolly Ranchers. Jaw Busters, I'm probably gonna give a much lower score because I don't like hard candies that much. And then we got the Atomic Fireball. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put all of these in my mouth at the same time and hopefully not die. So let's just do it. Yeah, that's a lot of flavors. This is a mistake. So, Jolly Rancher is still good. Jolly Ranchers gets a 4 out of 5 for me. I still like the Fireball a good bit too, actually. Give that a 4 out of 5 as well. Unfortunately, to the Jaw Buster, it takes approximately 3 hours to eat one of those, so it automatically brings down the score. But also, I just put it in my mouth with two other insanely different flavored candies, and I got nothing out of it. The flavor got nowhere. So it's gonna get a 2 out of 5. Our penultimate candy, Candy Buttons. What are Candy Buttons? Why do they exist? There's a lot here. We got 2 entire sheets. Let's just break one off. Oh no, it's got the paper on it. It's just, well. I don't know if it's because I just put a bunch of other candy in my mouth, but that has no flavor. This is how I'm breaking them off. The paper? Bro, this just got paper on it. Bro, it's got no flavor. Not even a hint. They're too small to like get anything, any joy out of them. I'm gonna have to say no. I think that's stupid. And Candy Button will be getting like it didn't make me angry. The paper? Bro, this just got paper on it. So I'm gonna give it a 1 and not a 0. But it's not good. But finally. Yeah. The Whack-A-Wax Wax Lips. I am super excited for this one. Now, why are they called wax? Can you eat this? I mean, obviously it's candy. It's sugar. Play now, chew later. Let's get the sunglasses on for maximum effect. It tastes awful. That's horrendous. It tastes like wax. How is this edible? What? The website says the wax lips and teeth are typically discarded
after everyone has had their fun and never consumed. While the paraffin wax used in production is technically safe to chew and eat, we suggest refraining. Glad I didn't swallow that. Ugh. Why? Just so you can look like an idiot on the internet? So this is probably the worst experience I had on this episode. That was extremely stupid. I don't get it. I'm giving that a -2/5. So there you have it. We have gone through so many candies. My paper is unreadable. My favorite candy was the Chuckles. My least favorite was right at the end, the wax lips. Overall, I gotta say that the 1950s candy is, it's okay. There were a lot more that I didn't like than there were that I did like. Almost all of the actual fruit flavored candies were pretty good. There was a lot that just was like boring or bland. And then we also had like a lot of peanut chocolate type candies, peanut and caramel, peanut and sugar, peanut and corn syrup. Like, people in the 50s love their peanuts. So it's, that's what you're going for here. But if you'd like to see me do the 1960s, 70s, 80s, or 90s, let me know down in the comments. I'll be happy to do that. I'm gonna go like drink a bunch of water, brush my teeth, and then have like an actual meal that gives me some kind of substance. Thank you for watching this episode of Your Everyday Nerd, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.